Right, I'm off to go and look at this job that you probably saw in my story yesterday about a sock outlet where the meter company had changed the meter, and they'd obviously tested that. They'd used that socket to test that they'd connected live and neutral correctly in the meter. I wouldn't want to be a meter monkey. Changing meters all day, every day, that'd do my nut in, that'd be so boring. Anyway, it's what they normally do. They go around afterwards once they've changed the meter, and they put a, they have a plug tester and they put it in a socket, and then they normally stick a sticker next to the meter saying, initialing it and saying what date and then what socket, sometimes lounge socket tested, all okay. Well, clearly they've tested this socket in the kitchen and it's, something's not right with it. Now it's normally reverse polarity or a lack of CPC. I'm gonna put my money on lack of CPC. What do you reckon?
Right, let's have a look what this is all about. Actually, it might be that the socket can't turn it off. I mean, it seems quite drastic for Eon to put it on just because they couldn't turn it off. Look. Later. It's all good. Might be purely because they couldn't shut that off. That rocker doesn't work. Perhaps the readings are duff on this side, perhaps. Yeah, that's what it is. So there's something wrong with the right hand side of that socket. It's not letting me do it. It's most likely the internal part of the socket. I don't think it's the actual cables or connections. Grout, haven't they? You can see all the way. This is the only way I can see to do it, because whoever did this grouted in the top of the socket. They should have sunk the socket in properly up above, or brought it below and cut round the socket below. Slap bang in the middle, obviously they realised what they'd done, probably a DIY, and then grouted in the top of the socket. So I can't put a new socket back because I'll have that gap all the way around the top of the socket. Which, no one wants to fill that with grout. perhaps you can get white PVC spacers and just cut, you know, cut the top half off. Spacers are probably a little bit narrower than that. So the kitchen's gonna get redone anyway. So I suggested if we cut the tile out fully, we can place the socket back fully in the wall. And they can, that's what they can have instead, which they're happy with. So I'm gonna do that, but all because of this. So the contacts in here must have gone faulty. I don't even, can't even see what brand it is. So yeah, that's my solution to this this particular problem. I'll just clean it all up and I'll extend. I might have to extend a couple of these. It might just fit perhaps. And we'll get the power back up and running for them. So yeah, not the prettiest and cleanest job, but yeah, it's what it is. Looks a bit horrible, looks a bit ugly, but like I said, the kitchen, they tell me they're going to get it done. They've been here a few years, so that's the next project for them. So at least it gets power back on. Let me go and turn it on and we'll recheck. Okay, it's all good. Perhaps I would have even improved the reading here now. I think it was before. Not that I imagine it changed too much. But now they have a working socket. 7.2. I just needed to take a sliver off, but it's quite hard sometimes just to take a shave sliver off, so I took a, like, you know, just under a centimetre.